Good evening. Thanks for joining us. I'm Philip Coleman. Lynn Brooks is on assignment. We're less than 24 hours away from the University of Alabama's A-Day game, and the excitement is beginning to rise at the capstone. You're looking live at the Walk of Champions from the WVUA Tower Cam, where thousands of fans will be tomorrow to get their first look at the 2012 Crimson Tide football team and the granite stones to honor the Crimson Tide's 14th national championship. And fans will have high expectations for this year's team in hopes that they bring home number 15. And the University of Alabama game day officials tell us they are expecting around 90,000 fans, and some of the Tide faithful are already here at the capstone. WVUA's Leah Knight scored that story.
There's a lot of excitement surrounding a national championship team, so we're expecting a full house.
Gina Johnson from Game Day Operations says the University of Alabama holds one of the highest attendance records for a spring football game. They plan on using all of their staff and resources just like a normal fall game.
People maybe who don't have access to tickets in the fall will be here on campus, many of them for the first time. So that's exciting for us.
And that's the case for Alabama fan Bryant Campbell, who traveled to Tuscaloosa for his first A-Day all the way from California with his dad. You may wonder where Bryant got his name.
From that old man over there. I'm named after Paul Bear Bryant, actually.
Bryant's dad, Al, is originally from Birmingham, and he says Alabama football is a family tradition.
I get excited for every Alabama game. It's tradition in my family. In the state of Alabama, you choose early, and I chose very early, so I've been an Alabama fan all my life.
The Campbells say they are very excited to be able to share this experience together and are anticipating a good scrimmage.
Get to see some of the young kids out there that didn't get a lot of playing time and see what we're going to be capable of this next year.
People are throwing around all kinds of expectations for the A-Day game. You can catch all the coverage on WVUA starting at noon. In Tuscaloosa, I'm Leah Knight.
And here's what you need to know for the big weekend. Gates open at 11. The Skills Challenge competition starts at 11:45. You can catch the Walk of Fame ceremony at 12:20. And kickoff for A-Day is set for 2 p.m. Also remember, your home team, WVUA TV, is the place for A-Day coverage. We'll have a live A-Day special edition of Crimson Tide Kickoff live from the capstone. That show runs from noon until 1 p.m. on Saturday, April 14th. Kickoff for A-Day is set for 2 o'clock. The game will be carried on Comcast Sports South. And Tuscaloosa is also gearing up for another big event tonight when a country music superstar makes an appearance at the Tuscaloosa Amphitheater. Country artist Luke Bryan is bringing his Tailgates and Tan Lines tour to the amphitheater tonight. Luke Bryan's special guests are Craig Campbell and Frankie Ballard. And we do have some time changes to tell you about for tonight's Luke Bryan concert there at the amphitheater. The gates will now open at 6:30, and the concert will start at 7:15 with the opening acts Craig Campbell and Frank E. Ballard. So how's the weather shaping up for all those big events in Tuscaloosa this weekend? Here now with a first look at Alabama's home team forecast is WVUA's chief meteorologist, Richard Scott.
Hey, Philip, good Friday evening to you. Great news is the weather for the weekend looking good. Even today, not that bad. We're looking southwest over Bryant-Denny Stadium. And an empty stadium today, expecting 90,000 people in Bryant-Denny tomorrow afternoon for A-Day happening in town. Gorgeous sunshine out there, so nice conditions, no doubt about that. 77 to Tuscaloosa. We have 80s down to the south, Hattiesburg 80, Evergreen 81 degrees, 75 in Birmingham, and over in Anniston. In the southeast, we're dry, not much cloud cover to deal with. We'll notice an increase in cloud cover later in the weekend. But the first half of the weekend, hey, looking nice out there. Saturday and Sunday, temperatures going to top out in the lower 80s. Again, for the weekend, plenty of sunshine for Saturday, A-Day happening. Sunday, though, low to mid 80s, kind of hot out there, but cooler at night. What about the rest of that forecast? And we'll look ahead towards the chances for some thunderstorms to talk about. Your forecast is coming up.
All right, thanks, Richard. Now, on your home team crime watch, a body found inside a Tuscaloosa County home sends authorities on a homicide investigation. According to Tuscaloosa Metro Homicide Captain Lloyd Baker, the body was discovered Thursday morning inside an abandoned mobile home on Sanders Ferry Road. Baker says the owners were cleaning out the mobile home and preparing to move it when they discovered the body. Now, Baker told us it appears that the victim was a woman, but her identification is unknown due to the condition of the body. And he says, based on the evidence at the scene, the victim may have been murdered. Dental records have been sent to forensics, and they hope to have results soon. And WVUA will bring you further developments in this story as they become available. Now, some local bars in Tuscaloosa are going interactive to promote safe driving with the Intox Box. Now, the Intox Box is an interactive bar breathalyzer, and the company that makes it says it's on par with local law enforcement with what they use. Now, the bar owners seem to like this new technology, which has the capability for a customer to call a cab when he or she is over the legal drinking limit. And with lots of football fans flocking into Tuscaloosa this weekend, bar owners say this is the perfect time to unveil this new feature, the Intox Box.
We definitely don't want anybody drinking and driving who's had too much, especially with A-Day coming up this weekend and football season hitting us in the fall.
And the Intox Box is being installed in 3 Tuscaloosa bars. And along with Tuscaloosa, the boxes are also popping up in other college towns, including Athens, Georgia, as well as